It's time for a different look. Check out the new faces of politics, traffic, and music as we discuss changes in the Constitution, bus driving, and Pinoy bands. I'm Nadia Trinidad.
Compare the Philippines before and after. DSWD Secretary Dinky Suliman joins us on the grill to talk about reforming social services through the Conditional Cash Transfer Program. I'm Twink Makariig.
Change your gullible facial expression when you're in front of that computer. We'll give you tips on how not to fall for the Facebook shutdown hoax and other scams on the Wacky Web tonight. My name is Gang. Let's start the makeover on the roof. Right, Twink, tonight we're going to talk about makeovers because this week is full of changes.
Yeah, as I happen to like makeovers, do you realize that it spawned this entire genre of television?
Yes.
Makeover.
Ambush makeover.
But sometimes do you notice that it's just the facial expression that changed? It is the same person with fancy makeup except that this time
she's having hair.
And those before and after pictures of weight loss clinics, you always notice that
the after is always smiling. So when I smile,
you lose weight.
But I'm talking about, you know, the shows like The Biggest Loser. They can't possibly be faking that.
Oh, they're not talking about
that. But you're right. The ambush makeovers, it's also like the demeanor, the way they stand, and the way they, etc. So that's probably...
And how they blossom under the spotlight, being given attention, di ba?
Like now, look at your hair.
This was an attempt at a makeover, not entirely successful.
Is it a curl?
I really tried to go for a
just makeover.
Tried.
You tried.
I tried.
How come you look the same?
I know, I look the same. I realize I can't. But anyway, here we are. Yes, tonight's about makeovers. Go.
What do you think of the makeovers in the news? Tweet us using the hashtag Bruha, B-R-E-W-H-A, or drop us a line on the ANC 24/7 Facebook page.
It's Makeover Madness on the Bruhaha. Some lawmakers call for a makeover of the Constitution after President Aquino said he would not run for public office in 2016. Even former Chief Justice Renato Puno says it's the perfect time to change the charter, as Aquino enjoys a high trust rating. Puno and other supporters believe charter change will address problems like the politicized judiciary and dirty elections. But critics say charter change could be a Trojan horse for former President Arroyo's return to power. For Malacanang, charter change is not a priority.
Nobody has presented an argument that validates that Chacha is urgent and that not doing so at the moment will place the country at risk. So it's really not a priority at this time.
Dagdag dun sa argumento, na mag-convince ang ating kababayan na hindi ito magbe-benefit ng ating Pangulo at saka ibang mga public officials.
I think this is an issue of trust. To me, until someone in power will be absolutely sure, and I will have no doubt that he will do it for the greater good of many, then I will go for charter change. But until there's that iota of doubt that something's in it for him, for somebody else, I won't go for charter change.
But what are you saying? So you have a president who enjoys this enormous trust rating, and you're saying that we still shouldn't go for it because there's still somebody out there who would
who
enjoy
are pushing it.
Huh?
But you have to read between the lines who are pushing it at this point.
Well, in this case, it was former Chief Justice Renato Puno.
And
well, the same people who probably pushed for it before, I have to say.
And allies of the former president, who is now a lawmaker.
Who were always pushing for it. And the thing is, so how can you raise this bogey of it's going to be this Trojan horse for the return of Arroyo to power when they don't have the numbers to do it?
I don't think she ever left. power.
No, but you can also look at it this way. Blogger Kokoy Dayo sent me his blog post. He said that, why are we so worried about charter change when there are still pressing problems that need to be addressed right now? And maybe if we can address poverty, a sound education policy and all of that, maybe we can think about the hereafter.
Unfortunately, charter change is a large thing, but because the trust rating we have, I mean, the trust we throw out for politicians, it's so low. Even the smallest things, we will always be wary of their agenda.
No, but who change, else will bring it about but politicians? You know, so
but
why
do we
not
really
under
need
this
now?
President? No, the thing is, it will take that long, so you have to start. That's my. It's
so
not
if
that
they start it now. 18 years from now, it might be passed.
Yes,
right.
Yes. So. do it now when you have a leader that people trust and when nobody's questioning his possible motive.
Possible agenda. Mm-hmm. Well, from changing the law, let's talk about a lawmaker who needs to probably change a few things. Party List Representative Eulogio Magsaysay could face an ethics complaint for calling a Philippine Airlines employee a menopausal toot. Toot meaning it starts with the letter B and ends with the word itch. The incident happened last month when ground attendant Sarah Ocampo failed to accommodate his request to be seated next to his son on a flight to Los Angeles. Ocampo and the PAL Employees Association condemned the remark as rude, sexist, and arrogant. Magsaysay naturally apologized, saying he thought Ocampo raised her voice but later on realized that her voice was just high-pitched.
I was called the repeatedly. And the menopausal ipabawal lang wang-wang ngayon. Babayad naman ako ng taxes ko. Wala akong utang sa gobyerno.
If I had prior knowledge na high-pitch siya, I wouldn't have been offended. Kung may nasaktan ako ng damdamin, humingi ako ng patawad.
Okay. Because he's fond of name-calling, we're naming Congressman Magsaysay our Bruja of the Week. We're all really quiet on the set right now. I have to say this. There are some airline employees who really act like bitches sometimes.
But there's a way of dealing with it.
It does not excuse the representative definitely for losing his top that way. And
there are ways of dealing with bad service if you're a client. Yeah. And name calling, basic rules of decency just says you don't resort to name calling. It's crass.
I have it in my thought balloon all the time, but it doesn't come out.
Well, I would like to laud this ground stewardess. Yes, because she is she was filing charges against him. Hindi siya madadaan sa sorry.
Yeah.
And that's the thing to do. Yeah. You sue the son of a toot.
Yeah.
Diba? Well, I also like to point out from what she said. I noted that this walang wang-wang has come to encompass all manner of petty abuse of authority and all that.
Right.
So I'm kind of natutuwa.
It has become a poetic, figuratively speaking, it just encompasses all bad attitude of people in power, I think.
And sorry just won't make it.
That's right.
Since we're on the subject of makeovers, let me close this subject by saying, or this particular topic by saying that Congressman Magsaysay, along with the makeover of your personality, you might want to consider some liposuction.
Oh my God. Here's more brouhaha about lawmakers who could use an attitude makeover. Senator Antonio Trillanes calls Senator Joker Arroyo the laziest senator as the two clash over Trillanes spending for 2009. The freed mutineer was the fourth top spender, while Arroyo was the thriftiest senator for the ninth straight year. Trillanes says the money went to his staff, who helped him file bills, while Arroyo did not even file a single bill. In response, Arroyo said, why should he be bothered by a mosquito?
We have one of the most number of employees. He only has 3 employees.
Yes,
I have 44. It's well within the quota provided by the Senate. We filed 347 bills. 18 of these bills were passed into law. Compare that now to Joker Arroyo, who failed to file a single bill.
Yeah.
In all his 18 years as a legislator, he has yet to file a bill. That would make him at least the laziest. For the past 9 years, he just lawyered. He lawyered only for GMA. Mm-hmm. So that would make him the most expensive lawyer.
Wow, it's a season for name calling. First, we have menopausal mosquitoes. Now we have menopausal mosquitoes.
I remember a time when senators were held in such high esteem. I was not a reporter then.
But,